Hello, today I'm going to give you 12 of my top tips to help you write a better medicine personal statement. My name's Cammy from Medic Mind, and I'm a second year medical student from the University of Birmingham. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how to strengthen your medicine application, start now by subscribing and pressing the bell button so you don't miss anything. The personal statement is your first chance to show off what you've been up to and how you've been preparing for medical school, so it's vital that you write a good statement. It can be overwhelming, especially to start writing, but if you stick around till the end of the video, I'll give you a good tip to get around this problem. Let me know in the comments if you've started writing your personal statement. So, without much further ado, let's get straight into it. So, number one, write down all of your biggest achievements. This can seem quite obvious, but actually a lot of people end up going on and on about their GP placements or how they've read X, Y, and Z, and they forget about the big things that they've achieved during their time at school. So these could be academic, such as winning a poster project competition, or social, so you could have been a volunteer of the month at your care home, or it could highlight key skills that you've learnt, perhaps by organising a big project as a prefect at school. So if you write all of these down and make a big list, then you definitely won't forget to slot them in later. So number two, try to make your motivation as original as possible. Most people will say something along the lines of, I love science and I love helping people. And although that's all great and everything, doesn't sound very passionate, does it? I also imagine that quite a lot of people this year might be using the NHS response to the COVID-19 outbreak in their personal statement. That might just be something to think about. So your passion has to jump out from the very beginning of your personal statement. So don't be afraid to rewrite your introduction until you're really happy with it. It's up to you how you start your introduction. Some people like to use a personal anecdote, which can be a good idea. It definitely will make your application different from others. However, if you're going to use an anecdote, make sure that it's realistic and applicable to your course. If you're applying for an intercalating or perhaps a more traditional course like Oxbridge, then you're going to want to focus more on the science in your motivation. We cover this in another video, so check the description to find that link. If you're unsure of how to phrase your motivation for medicine, keep watching and I'll give you some tips on how to get around this later on in the video. Number three, do not lie. This is a really important point. We all exaggerate and embellish our experience a little bit in both our CV and our personal statement, but it's so important that you don't lie. If you're caught out with this, the university can reject your offer, and even all of your universities might reject your offer. So it's just not something you want to risk, and it's definitely not something they're looking for in a future doctor. So don't lie, easy as that. If you've said you read a specific book, read it from cover to cover. You don't want to be caught out. Especially if you mention this in your personal statement, they are quite likely to ask you a question about it in the interview. So a decent tip here is to reread your personal statement before going into the interview. I'll come back to how you can perhaps adjust your statement a little bit so that you can direct the questions that you want to answer at your interview. So number four, link your extracurriculars and basically everything back to how it will make you a better doctor. So I'm sure you know extracurriculars are so important in developing all those skills that will make you a great doctor. So do show off what you've achieved during your time at school, whether that be jazz club, debating club, or if you're in the first team for hockey, whatever it is, jot it down. The universities will be really happy to hear about them. But what is important here is, firstly, you link it back to why it'll make you a great medic. So what have you learned from those team building exercises? What's challenged you? How have you developed as a person? Be sure to draw out all of those skills that you've learned through all of your extracurriculars. And secondly, mention that you want to continue these at university. Medical schools want people who are well-rounded and who can represent the schools in other ways than just academically. So number five, reflect when talking about your work experience. Everyone has different contacts, and universities understand that some people find it a lot easier or a lot harder to find work experience than other people. So by now, hopefully, you've secured most, if not all, of your work experience. But remember, it's so much better to organise it yourself rather than, say, your mum organising work experience with a top brain surgeon that so happens to be her best friend. So if you spent ages emailing all the hospitals endlessly asking for work experience, then do mention that you've tried to sort it yourself. Show initiative, because that is what medical schools want to hear. And remember that even if you've got just a GP work experience sitting in consultations and your best friend has work experience shadowing a top brain surgeon. It doesn't matter. You can both draw incredible experiences out of both of these shadowing placements. If anything, you'll probably get more out the GP one. So definitely don't be put off by this. Another key point, as with extracurriculars, is that you must reflect. If I tell you that I spent my first semester at medical school writing a 3,000 word essay on reflection, hopefully this might give you the idea that medical schools do love reflection. So what did you learn? What challenges were you faced with? You need to show that you understand that medicine is not easy and there are negative aspects. But instead of just pointing out those negative aspects, make sure that you do show how you would deal with that as a medic. You'll also need to show your understanding of multidisciplinary teams. So on your work experience, chat to absolutely everyone, from the administrative team to the nurses, through the doctors to the top brain surgeons. You need to show that you've talked to as many people as you can so you get an understanding of the team as a whole, because everyone is so important. This shows that you've talked to a lot of people and you've got a lot of point of views and you have a better idea of medicine as a whole. Number six, you don't need to include everything. Lots of students will try to cram in as much as they can, but admissions teams will much rather hear about one experience and everything you learned from it, all the stuff you've drawn from it, what challenged you, etc., etc., rather than hearing about 10 different small experiences that you've given no detail about. That's not very useful in your personal statement. So I mentioned earlier that there are tricks to prepare for possible questions that they may ask you in interviews. So in your personal statement, mention a certain point, but don't go into too much detail. Obviously, you need to explain why you've mentioned it in your statement, but don't write too much about it. So you could say that you particularly enjoyed chapter 3 in book X, and maybe pop in a sentence for your reasoning, but don't go into too much detail, because that's literally giving the interviewers a question on a plate that they can ask you at interview. This will help you to be more prepared for the interview, but don't count on this. They might not ask you the question. Number seven, remember the line and character limit. It's so important to start early so that you can really write everything out and you have lots of time to do so. It's so much better to write too much and then cut down later rather than restricting yourself from early on and then missing key points. So you can give a first long draft to a teacher or a medical professional or a friend so they can suggest what you should and shouldn't include. But remember, if you do need help editing your personal statement, make sure you get in touch with Medic Mind. So when you do begin to cut down, remember those 4,000 characters. You've got to ask yourself, why have I included this? Is it absolutely necessary? And then you can cut out all the jargon that doesn't tell the medical school that you absolutely have to be taken. So some people might not actually understand that it's not a fancy English essay. You can cut out all of those extravagant descriptive words. You've got to keep it snappy and to the point. Number eight, write it yourself. So I've mentioned that you can get all sorts of people to read over your personal statement and give you some suggestions for edits, but you've got to remember that this is your statement. So if you don't believe in a suggestion they're making and that's not something you would say, then don't change it. It's got to be what you would say. This may not seem important, but at interview, if the language you're using in real life is really different from the language you used in your personal statement, this can be really obvious. So feel free to reject advice, even this. This is quite literally a statement that's personal to you. So if you don't believe in the changes that someone mentions, don't include it. Number nine, don't forget good structure. Structure is really important. You could split your personal statement into separate paragraphs, which makes it a lot easier to read. So they could be split up according to topic, so say your work experience, your academic achievements, etc., etc. Another important point is that you don't have to write it in order. Start with what you find easiest to write about. The first bit is always the hardest bit to write. So say in my case, I found writing about my extracurriculars the easiest bit to write about. So you could start with that or whatever you find easiest. I would also recommend not starting with the introduction, only as after writing about your work experience, etc., You'll have a better idea of how to phrase your motivation in your introduction. Another key point is that flow is so, so important. By using a connecting word or connecting phrase really simply, it can help the reader understand how you've gone from paragraph A to paragraph B. So when talking about your work experience, you could mention that your motivation for medicine, which was the previous paragraph, the introduction, was developed during your work experience. A statement that isn't cohesive is difficult to follow and difficult to read. So number 10, check, check and double check. Make sure you've gone over your statement not once, but multiple times, and again, get other people to check it. Because grammar and spelling mistakes are very easy ways to both gain marks and lose marks. The universities will be sat there with a tick box, making sure that you've got all of your spelling right, and you need to show that you can write a good essay, as you are going to have to do this at medical school. Number 11, do your research. As well as attending extra lectures and doing a lot of reading, you need to show that you understand what makes a good doctor. So I would recommend reading the GMC's Good Medical Practice, perhaps reading up on confidentiality, and reading lots of newspaper articles, obviously from good sources. All of these will give you a better idea of what makes a good doctor. I'd also recommend reading into all of the links and the suggested reading that the universities that you're applying to suggest. That way you can drop in keywords, and if they recognize it, that really shows that you are the ideal candidate. Number 12, don't be too hard on yourself. I've mentioned that you should try and make your statement as original and as different to others as you can, so you can stand out. But at the end of the day, you're applying for medicine, like they're gonna be similar in some way or another. So don't stress too much. Some universities even put more weighting on the personal statement than others do, so don't spend longer than you need to spend on it. So as promised, a final bonus tip. When you're stuck, make sure you just take a break. Go and do something else, take your mind off it, and then when you come back, you're gonna have a fresh pair of eyes and you'll be able to analyze your personal statement so much better than you would have been able to before. You should be writing about something you're really passionate about, so show off and enjoy it. You deserve that recognition. So make sure you hit the thumbs up button and you share with all of your friends if you found this useful. Make sure you subscribe to see our new videos coming up. And if you need any further help with your medicine personal statement, make sure to get in touch with the Medic Mind team, as they're always on hand to help. So thanks for watching. Best of luck writing your personal statement, and I'll see you in our next video in the personal statement series.